Hi there, I'm Alan Eaton. I work for UNH Cooperative Extension, and I'm here to talk about ticks today and to collect some ticks. This is a perfect spot where we've got lots of thick brush and tall grass. It's a really good tick spot, and it's a place where I've got to do some field work, and so it's a good place to talk about protecting yourself from ticks. One of the things that I do when I head out to go collect ticks is to tuck pant legs into socks. If you do this, any ticks you encounter tend to stay on the outside of your clothing, because most of the ticks you run into are going to be down around your ankles. So if you keep your pant legs tucked in, it means the ticks, which tend to crawl up, will stay on the outside of your clothing where they're easier to spot. So in addition to tucking pant legs in, another thing to consider is using repellents. There's all kinds of repellents that we've got. I'm often asked which brand is the best. I don't buy by brand, I buy by looking at the label. And I look to see what it says it controls or repels. That's one clue. If it doesn't say ticks on the label, then it's not likely to work on them. And I also look at the list of active ingredients and the percentages. This one has 19% DEET. DEET is a common insect repellent active ingredient. This particular one has picaridin, 7% active ingredient. If we're talking about ticks, probably the most effective active ingredients are either DEET or picaridin or undecanone, but you can look at the labels and decide for yourself which ones you choose. If you decide to use one of these, the place to put it is on your socks or pant legs lower down. There's no need to put it elsewhere. If I were wearing shorts, then on my lower legs and around my ankles. There's still another option as well, and that is, if I'm going in an area that's a little bit wet, I often put on boots. I like that because it keeps my feet dry, but also these rubber boots are so slick that ticks can't get hold of them. Most of the ticks you encounter are down here, and if they try to grab on, these rubber ones are too slippery for the ticks to climb up. So that's another alternative instead of repellents. Our most common tick in New Hampshire is here, the American dog tick. And you can tell this species apart from any of the other ticks we have in New Hampshire by the fact that it's ornate. It has colored lines, these light lines on the dark background on the male and the dark lines on the light background of the female. So if you see a species that's ornate, it has colored dots, dashes, squiggles, it's most likely American dog tick. Almost zero chance of disease with that species. Our second most common tick is the black-legged tick, and this one used to be called deer tick. This is the one that has the ability to transmit Lyme disease, babesiosis, and anaplasmosis in New Hampshire. And you can tell it apart from American dog tick by the fact that it's not ornate. There's no colored dots and squiggles and dashes and so forth on this thing. So if you see a tick that's not ornate, it might be this one. If you see one that is ornate, your chance of getting a disease from that one, from a bite from that, is almost zero. The most important thing to reduce your risk of getting a tick-borne disease is to check yourself for ticks every day. For me, it's easiest to do that at the end of the day. You got to take off your clothes to do that. If you don't have a loved one, a significant other to help, then you need a couple of big mirrors or handheld mirrors so you can see your back and so forth. Check everywhere. They especially like to attach around your waistline where the clothing restricts them, but there are other places as well. If you check daily during tick season, and that starts in March and it goes through April, May, June is the riskiest month, then it stops in early July and then starts up again in October and November. If people in New Hampshire would check themselves for ticks daily, then the incidence of Lyme disease in our state, which is currently third in the nation, would absolutely plummet. You can read more about how to protect yourself from ticks at my tick publication, which is on our website at extension.unh.edu.